If you had seen my video on Blurbuster's low lag Vsync ON, you would know that its configuration is simple. Just find the real refresh rate of your monitor via testufo.com/refresh rate. Subtract one of these values, 0.01 being the suggested one. Set the result as the framerate limit in RTSS. And finally enable Vsync and low latency mode in NVCP. However, I have never tested whether this method really gives a lower latency than vanilla Vsync, nor have I ever considered the fast sync instead, until now. All thanks to the great piece of software that is Intel PresentMon 2.1. So I used the same testing methodology as in my previous video, 300 samples from each of 10 runs per scenario. Since I also wanted to try every single RTSS framerate limiter mode, the total number of scenarios was 40. Basic maths tells us that I clicked my bloody left mouse button a staggering of 120,000 times. Well, actually more, because I foresaw and discarded the inevitable outlier runs. This is to say three things. I care a lot about accurate data. I will get carpal tunnel syndrome if I don't build an external autoclicker soon. I will feel sad if you don't support such a build via my Ko-fi, PayPal, or Amazon links in description. With that out of the way, the first graph you're about to see shows the average latencies of low lag Vsync ON with its usual 5 frame limits using the 4 RTSS frame limiter modes, one by one. As you can see, Async offers a latency reduction compared to vanilla Vsync with all 5 FPS caps, but real refresh rate minus 0.1 is much better than the usually suggested value of 0.01, at least on my PC. In fact, you must remember what the Blurbuster said. Experiences will vary per system and per game engine. In other words, these results are only valid for my specific configuration, so you should experiment on your own machine. Switching to Front Edge Sync, the only scenario where latency is lower than vanilla Vsync, is again 0.1. And the same goes for Back Edge Sync, but neither is as good as Async. Will the RTSS Reflex implementation save the day? Unfortunately, no, as all scenarios basically deliver the same latency of plain old Vsync. Therefore, if I wanted the lowest lag Vsync ON behavior on my PC, I should use RTSS default frame limiter and a frame limit of 59.85/16.79. But what happens when I use fast sync instead of Vsync? Let's see. While with Front Edge Sync the latency is slightly higher than 22.30, i.e. the best case scenario of low lag Vsync ON, Async and Back Edge Sync both halve the lag. As the difference between the highest latency of Async and the lowest latency of Back Edge is less than half a millisecond, they could all be considered equal. However, I wouldn't recommend their minus 0.1 scenario, because it has an higher standard deviation than the other four. Finally, what about RTSS Reflex? Well, it's way better than before, but apparently still not the best. Therefore, if I wanted the lowest lag fast sync behavior on my PC, I should probably use RTSS Back Edge Sync frame limiter and a frame limit of 59.94/16.79. Now, a quick comparison of these two best options in motion. On paper, low lag Vsync ON, with its loosest difference of 0.1, should produce frequent micro stuttering, which low lag fast sync, with its tighter difference of 0.01, could alleviate. And yet, as you can see from the frame time graphs and the frame rate matrix just above, both methods offer perfectly stable FPS in this short test. This means that there could only be one variable at play here, their respective latency, which we now know is lower with fast sync. That's why it's the option I'd prefer, unless for some reason it worked badly, because sometimes it sure can. In a nutshell, trial and error is the key to finding the sweet spot, or should I say, sweet setting, for your particular combination of hardware and software. Until then, farewell for now.